Doma Sports Talk, worldwide, with some news from the world of boxing. So y'all know what time it is. You ain't in a rush to get concussed. Now, pretty big news in the super middleweight division happened about a day or two ago. Just getting around to it. And that would be George Groves, one of the good ones, man. George Groves, English cat, 28-4, right, over the years. He has retired. Right? And when I heard that the first time, I'm going to be honest, first thing I said, well, you know, yeah, retiring, because at the end of the day, you know, I'm not going to go through the whole rigmarole anymore. He's 30 years old, I think, right now, and he's, you know, like, hey, I got all my faculties, I'm up out of here, right? And that's probably when a fighter, basically, you know, similar to Andre Ward, man, I'm not going to be fighting all these fights anymore, I'm done with that. But I do think if someone comes to George Groves and say in 8 months, and say, hey, let's say the James DeGale, Chris Eubank, junior winner comes out and calls him out because he has issues with those, which means he beat both of them and they would probably want to fight him. And if it could be lucrative or something lucrative in England, I think he probably would fight. I just think he's just not going to go through all of the rigmarole, all the hard things that you have to do to be a boxer. We see him on Boxing Day, but you know, the training camps and all of the things, you know, the getting down in weight, that's a pain. Right. And, you know, the thing that boxers are weighing right now is the fact of, you know, getting out of the game with your faculties, and especially fighters that have been in fights with fighters that are not the same today. Like in George Groves' case, you would be talking about Edward Gutknecht. And that was about four fights ago for George Groves. And, you know, the guy is not the same anymore. I don't even think he's walking and talking. Right. So when you're in fights like that, it takes something out of you because you do realize what this fight game is all about. And it's happened to also, you know, a guy, Adesalamov, oh, his name, when he was fighting your boy, the young, the Cuban guy. I can't think of his name right now, cruiserweight / heavyweight. It'll come to me later. He hadn't been the same after that. You know, he did get into the tournament, the WBWS tournament in cruiserweight division. Mike Perez, that's what I'm talking about. But he's probably never been the same after that fight with Adesalamov. I can't remember his name, you know, but you know, you guys know what I'm talking about. They had a nice dust-up, one of those fights where the fans say, hey, that was exciting. Yeah, but this guy's never been the same since. And then the fighter who goes on, who wasn't as hurt as bad, but has a psychological problem. So it can happen. So George Groves is out of the game. You know, and you know, the headlines lately is because, you know, Carl Froch, they asked Carl Froch about him. Right, and Carl Froch, you know, said some things, and I thought it was perfectly normal for Carl Froch to say, but he got some feedback from it, even up into Andre Ward. And I hear, you guys know, I'm not into Twitter and all that other stuff. What is it, Snapchat? What's the other one? Twitter, Snapchat, and what's the other one? Instagram and all that stuff. That's too much stuff popping up. But I understand that's what the world is doing, especially the younger generation. It's the need, necessity for these people. Good for you guys. So you probably know a little bit more, but he, you know, his riff with Andre Ward, even James DeGale, you know, things came out. And I'm thinking, you know, well, Carl Froch, you know, he just said, I won't miss him. You know what I mean? He won't. They had a big dust up with these two. You know, they don't like each other. He said, you know, he was good. He won the title on his fourth attempt, which he has respect for. But he doesn't feel he'll miss him, and he doesn't know if the British public will miss him. And he said, more or less, there's nothing else out there for George Groves to do because his fight with Callum Smith that he lost, right? It wasn't close. It's not like, hey, we need a rematch or anything. So those are things Carl Froch was going to say. But maybe my expectation for Carl Froch, you know, seeing, you know, following the guy for a while, because I like Carl Froch, I expected that. But Andre Ward came and called him old and bitter, right? Because he always says something negative about Andre Ward. And Andre Ward is the guy, the only guy to beat him, he didn't avenge his loss. So, you know, there's a little bitterness there. So Andre Ward came and got on him, and he got into something with James DeGale as well. I think George Groves got into something with James DeGale. So, you know, there's a lot of little things going on around George Groves' retirement. But at the end of the day, I think this. George Groves, this is just me, you know. George Groves is going to be a Hall of Famer. British for sure, right? He's one of the good ones because he got a title, a real title, WBA style in the super middleweight division, and it wasn't exactly super weak at the time. He did get a title, you know, and that's big. Now, It's not as big as it used to be when it was only one champion in each division, but he did get a title. And he was in some legendary fights when you're talking England. When you're talking 80,000 in Wembley, now you only would think, hey, did Anthony Joshua fight there yesterday? 80,000 in Wembley? No. George Groves versus Carl Froch. Boom. 80,000. That was the second biggest draw in the history. Second biggest attendance in the history of Wembley Stadium. George Groves had something to do with that. That build-up was good. And at the time of the build-up, I'll be honest, you know, even though I like Carl Froch more, I wanted Carl Froch to win the fight. But on the build-up, I was with George Groves because he was getting under Carl Froch's skin. And so that started making me think, look, Carl, are you entitled or what? He's trying to fight you. And what, he's supposed to blow hot air up your butt? He's trying to beat you. So he's not going to be saying no nice things to you, right? So that even though I was going for Carl Froch to win, I thought the build-up and how George Groves was there to win the fight and to get under the skin of Carl Froch, I thought that was awesome. Similar to Tyson Fury, what he did to Vladimir Klitschko in that first fight. Get under his skin. Normally, you're in charge, Vladimir, most of the time. Same with Carl Froch. Now here's somebody who's not abiding by the rules and is not happy to be here. He's going to get under your skin and he's trying to win the fight. Boom. I like that, right? The same thing with Kell Brook and Amir Khan. Amir Khan basically keeps telling Kell Brook, don't say anything. The way you talk is why we're not going to have a fight. Who the hell are you? I'm trying to beat you up. I can beat you up. Well, I'm not. I don't care if you got, I'm not a fan of you. That's what some of the fighters have to realize. But once they start getting entitled and getting in these positions, then they expect other boxers to be like fans. No, not happening. And so, therefore, no matter what boxer I like, it doesn't matter. If the opponent is not supposed to be coming up here overly respecting you. His job is to knock your head off. So, and that's why sometimes they should understand those type of things. So, at the end of the day, Carl Froch enjoys retirement. George Groves just enjoys retirement. I don't know how long that'll be. There's so many things out there happening that I do think that he might come back one day. When it comes to these retirements, I didn't do a fighter that I really like, and that's David Haye. I think I'm going to have to come back and give David Haye respect of doing a video about him and his career and his retirement as well. I missed that one. I will get back. But George Groves, 28-4, pretty good fighter. We're going to definitely say a good fighter. This Hall of Fame could possibly be coming his way. I don't even know if British have the Hall of Fame, but I'm pretty sure in British lore, he will be there as one of their good fighters. That's for sure. As far as the retirement goes, let's see how long that lasts. I suspect, right, that he might, in about a year or something might happen where he'll probably come back fight once or twice without going through all these other fights to get to a fight. Somebody significant calls him out for something for a lot of money, then he probably will probably take that. That's just my opinion. As of right now, George Groves is retired. And congratulations on a good career. Doma Sports Talk. Worldwide. And I'm about to hear y'all.